Happy Monday, everybody. It's Michelle Lloyd here, founder of United Artspace, and I'm back for my 11 a.m., depending on where you are in the world, it's 11 a.m. here, for my Motivational Monday. And I am founder of United Artspace, and I know that we have lots of new people following us at the moment. So hello, if you're new around here. We have a virtual art studio, which is our free group, and we have a membership for our members of United Artspace who are all learning how to make art their living. And I turn up every Monday to you all to give you motivational tips. And very excited to announce, actually, that in January, I've got a date for your diary, the 7th of January to the 14th of January. I will be running the yearly workshop, which is Make 2021 Your Best Year Yet. Now, I know for some people that isn't going to be difficult after the year that we've just had. It's been a pretty rocky road, hasn't it? Which is why I'm very, very, very excited to run these workshops again. I ran them in January, just gone. And, you know, for some people, the plans that we made in January were turned upside down this year. But for many that took part in those workshops, despite everything that happened in our hub community, they made this year their best year yet. And I will be running these workshops in January and sharing stories of how, despite everything that's happened, people have still made this year their best year yet, me included. I've hit all my goals this year. I can't believe it. And I'll be sharing how I've done that and how other people have done that in those workshops. So for now, keep that in your diary. Save the date for the 7th of January. They'll run for 2 weeks. And I'll be opening enrollment to the Hub as well. So it's a great introduction to the Hub and what happens when you become a member of United Artspace. But even if you don't want to become a Hub member, I'll be running these free workshops. Everyone tells you how much I pour into them and I love doing them. So I'll be sending out some information soon on how you can register. But for now, just pop the date in your diary. And then I've got something else planned in the February. We'll be coming together to do a nice big art challenge together. I haven't run a big art challenge for a long time, so I'm already getting excited about next year. And so in those January workshops, I want to help you get excited about next year as well. And I want to help you start to make a plan so that you can focus on what's most important. So anyway, I today wanted to talk about framing, because I've had a great question come into my Hub membership this week, or was it last week, asking, is it necessary to frame my work before I approach a gallery? And it was a difficult one to answer in a message, so I thought I would answer it today on video. Because it's a great question, and it actually raises a lot of other points off the back of that question. So I'll answer this, and this is just my opinion, of course. So is it necessary to frame my work before I approach a gallery? The short answer is no, it's not necessary, but there is more to it. So the reasons are kind of threefold. So the first thing to consider is it really depends on your work. So not all work needs framing, and some work sells better without a frame. You know, a frame is a very personal choice. I never framed any of my artwork. I hung them from poles. So I created big, huge 2 meter by 1.5 meter pieces, and I actually made kind of really big thick poles. I guess they were like curtain poles, but much thicker, and had a bit of a more industrial feel to them. And I stitched the canvas and fed the canvas onto the pole. So it hung, it was kind of raw. And they went into exhibitions and sold out. So you don't need to frame your artwork, is the first thing I would say. It really does depend on how you want to present your work. And this was one of the biggest things I learned in the last year of my days at uni. I'll never forget them saying to me, you know, when you've finished your work, it doesn't end there. The way you present your work is so important. And we did a whole big piece on presentation, and it's always stuck with me. And so playing around with the way you present your work, the way you hang it, the way you frame it, does it need to be framed? Can you hang it from wire? There are so many ways that you can present your artwork, and framing is one of them. But playing around with that presentation as part of your art practice is really important. So playing around with the different ways of how you hang your work, how it is presented, is really important. And that's why I love this question, because it reminded me of that advice that I was given at uni about presentation and playing around with the different types of frames. How does your work change? And I did a lot of work on presentation in my own work. And that's when I decided to go against the grain and put it on poles and not do it in a traditional way. And that's one thing I would say is, don't be afraid to play with the way you present your work. I totally went in a different direction to the way work is usually presented, and I sold all my work. So if I'd have, you know, limited myself thinking, oh God, if I put it on a pole, it probably never sell, I would never have done that. I kind of threw caution to the wind, and I went against the grain, and I actually took that decision not based on selling. I just wanted it on a pole, and I wanted it to be raw, and it all sold out to big loft conversions in Paris. So that's where they were hung. And so that taught me a lot, actually. So there's part of this, it's about how you want your work to be seen. How do you want your work to be engaged with, and being confident enough to say, this is how I want it to be put out there. This is how I want it to hang. That being said, that brings me to my second point, is it depends on the gallery. So if you are approaching a gallery and it's a certain type of gallery, this brings me to another point, that galleries are all different. There is no one type of gallery. There are so many different types of gallery. There are commercial galleries that are there to sell. And within that bucket of commercial galleries, there are lots of different types of galleries. There are everyday touristy galleries. There are high-end galleries. There are galleries that are, you know, they probably don't even sell framed work because their customers like deep canvas, boxed canvases. So there are so many different types of galleries that it's very difficult to answer that question in a yes or no way, because you have to do your homework when you're looking into galleries, because some galleries will only accept framed artwork because their customers prefer to buy a framed artwork. And it's usually down to what the gallery likes and what their customers will buy. And so when you are approaching a gallery, it's a really good idea to have a look. Are they selling framed artwork? Are they selling non-framed artwork? Look at how they like to be approached, because sometimes a gallery wants gallery ready work. That means it's ready to hang. You've done all the legwork. They just want to take it off you and put it on the wall. So understanding a gallery is great advice, by researching them, looking at how they present their work, going into the gallery, following them on social media. You'll start to get a sense of what they want from an artist. And there is nothing wrong with just having the conversation. And this is why I say, no, it's not necessary to frame your work, because even if the gallery wants gallery ready work, if you go in with your work, and actually one of our members gave great advice, Kelly gave great advice to the member who asked this question, and said that actually she frames a couple of her pieces, or suggested to this person that frame a couple of pieces so that you can go into the gallery with your portfolio of work and show how a couple of them look framed in different ways. And I think that's a great idea to show people that, you know, it can look this way or it can look that way. And if you have a conversation with a gallery about the work, you know, the presentation is something that can be changed. It can be adapted. The work can't. So a gallery will really know based on your work whether they'll be able to work with you or not, because, you know, a good gallery will say to you, yeah, I like the work, but maybe we need to think about the way it's framed because I don't think I can sell it like this. Or we need to maybe not frame it. Or, you know, you can have a really nice conversation with the gallery about presentation, and you can ask them, you know, do you feel that a certain type of frame sells better in your gallery? Do people prefer wooden? Do they prefer ornate? And that's a conversation that you can have, because it differs completely depending on the type of people who are buying. So the reason I say no, it's not necessary, is because I think if you approach it in the sense of going with some examples of showing how you've thought about the presentation, I think, you know, it could look work like this, but I'm open to ideas, then I think that's a great situation to be in when you go in for a conversation with a gallery. And then make it a two-way conversation. Sharon did this when she was approaching her galleries. You know, her work wasn't at the place that the gallery wanted it to be, and they said it's just not ready. And they gave her amazing feedback on, you know, for us to take your work, this is how we'd expect it to be presented. So if she had waited and for it all to be ready in a certain type of way, she would never have got that amazing feedback. So there's nothing wrong with putting yourself out there, knowing that maybe things aren't quite ready yet, and you know that, but put yourself out there for the feedback and say, you know, I'm still exploring the way I want to present my work. I'm really open to ideas, but this is the collection of work that I have. And galleries are really looking for an artist who has found their stride, you know, found their thread, who has work that they're really interested in and think, yes, I've got a customer that would buy this. I know where you're coming from, and they get excited about your why and why you're making. That's what a gallery is looking for. But again, some galleries, again, it's all different, and different types of people run different types of galleries. Some galleries might know lots about framing, and you'll get someone who runs a gallery and they know nothing about framing. So it is all subjective. So you do have to do your homework. Really do think about your presentation and show to someone else that you have considered presentation and you've tried it in different ways, and this is what your thoughts are. Have a look at other people and the way they're presenting their artwork. Look at the types of frames people are using, because frames are so personal. You know, if you choose a frame and it can completely change your artwork, if you play around with like an old traditional wooden frame versus an ornate frame, what does that do to your artwork? Ask the question, because it will change the feel. And yes, a frame can really put somebody off an artwork. So that is something to consider in how you show that work. So to recap, yeah, do your homework. How do you want your work to look and feel? Play around with the presentation. There are two, there's a balancing act here of how you want your work to look and feel and how you take ownership of that. Like I did with my work that I was hanging on poles. You know, a lot of people would have said to me, that's never going to sell. Who's going to buy just the raw canvas hanging off a pole? And I did it and they sold out, because of that reason, because it was so unique. You know, it was different to anything else in the exhibition. But also there is another element of looking at what's selling and making your work presentable to fit an audience. So it's getting that balancing act of where you want to fit and how you want to change your work to fit. And some people just go their own way and go, this is how I'm doing it, and that's it. Or some people adapt. The pencil neck, Owen Garrett is a great example of this. If you Google him, he's a fantastic pencil artist, realistic, very, very realistic. In fact, I think he's colorblind, which is why he draws in monochromatic. And he draws a lot of the oil industry and men at work and anything related to the oil industry, because he's got a connection to that industry. And what he found was his work was being bought to present members of staff in big oil companies like a 10-year gift if they'd been there for a long time, or so they were becoming giftable pieces of art. So what he did is he started to frame them and put a presentation plaque inside so people could have the name engraved and the reason that they were getting the artwork as a gift. And this catapulted his art and totally raised the prices and the desire and the need for them. So that's one way of adapting your work, you know, and changing the way they're presented to appeal. So those two things to think about, and how you want to adapt. So how much flexibility you want to give to change the way your work is presented to fit a gallery maybe, or to fit an opportunity, or do you want to go all out on, I'm doing it my way, and this is how I'm doing it. So, but interestingly, Kelly did add as well that by framing her work, it's made her feel more professional. And I thought that was a great point to raise too, because it is how you want to feel about your work. And she wants to appeal to galleries and appeal professional. So she spent a lot of time investigating framing, and she said it's made her feel more presentable and more professional. And she's also made a very good connection with a framer and got so many more opportunities from her art world from making that connection with the framer. So I thought that was really interesting as well. It just all depends. There is no right or wrong. I'm just going to check the comments and say hello to you all. And good morning, Lisbeth. Shannon, hello. Maribel, Karen's here. Nikki, good morning. Leah, I really need the motivation at the moment. Oh, Leah. Good morning, Jenny, Shannon. Hello, Hannah. Oh yeah, Elizabeth, these workshops will be a fantastic refresher, even for us hubsters. Yes, we all have to do the plan. And if you missed the beginning, I'm running workshops in January where I'm going to help you get focused and get fired up with what it is that you want to get out of next year. And doing that, honestly, is an incredible exercise. And I'm going to show you how things have really changed for me over the years and how I've kind of created the life that I live now. It's an incredible story, actually, and one that I never believed that I could do myself. So, thank you. Thank you, Leah. Nice comment about my hair. Good morning, Romeo. Hello, Stacey. Noreen's on as well. Hello, Mike. Hello, Sinead. Ah, nice. So Ryan, I put my A5 pieces on mini easels. Lovely. Yeah, motivation is important for keeping going. It sure is. Karen's painting away and listening. It's so good to hear your innovative voice. Oh, thank you. Yeah, Ryan says, I agree that framing is a very personal thing. If someone likes my work, I'm happy for them to frame it the way they choose after buying it, of course. Yeah. Yeah. Shannon says, I do this with my small pieces too. It's quite a fun way of displaying them. People seem to like it. Yeah, it's good when you start to find. I use antique items to frame most of my feathers. Yeah, Judy artwork. Hello, Lottie. Kindred spirit, I love it. In the mountains, wonderful. Yeah, the frames can change a piece. I've actually not bought a piece because of the frame the artist used. It ruined the piece. I've been the same, Shannon. I've seen so many artworks. And this is an important point, actually, to get across to your potential buyers. I have seen so many artworks and I've seen the frame and it's totally put me off buying it. But you know, we can take it out of the frame. And this is the thing, when you're a potential buyer, you don't actually consider that. You just look and you think, no, I don't like the frame. That's not going to go, you know. And it's actually our job as the artists to actually get this across and say, you know, this is the frame I've chosen, but you're very welcome to frame it yourself, or this is how it looks in a different type of frame. So it's a really good point, isn't it, of we need to communicate this to people, because and prompt people to say, you know, you can change the frame. I know this sounds really simple, but people don't, even as artists and me knowing that, if I see an artwork and I don't like the frame, it puts me off. And I guess another reason is, and this is interesting because I've just created selling lessons for the Hub members, and I wish I'd have thought of this because I could have included it in the lesson. But one of the fears or reservations if people are buying and they don't like the frame is, well, I'm paying for it. So it's a trigger in someone where they go, yeah, I'm not going to buy that because I don't like the frame. I'm not going to pay for something I don't like. So there is something around that, about, you know, if maybe there's a pricing thing around, if you take the frame away, it makes it a little bit cheaper. I don't know. But yeah, it's something to think about if you are framing. And whether you want to give that option to your customers, because it can increase your sales. Hello, Catherine. Lovely to see you. You've been busy painting. Lovely. Oh, what a lovely compliment, Poppy. Currently unfollowing the 1 million groups I'm in on Facebook so I can focus on the ones that matter, like this one. Oh, thank you. Got your voice on in the background for motivation. I love it. Oh, Stacey, tell me about it. Another year has gone. It's crazy. This year particularly has frightened me because it's just gone in a flash. Janet says, are there any disadvantages in making your own frames? Should we steer clear of this as it limits how the work is presented? But the work is then more unique with its own bespoke frame. Would that benefit the work? No right or wrong here. I know lots of people that make their own frames. In fact, there are some people inside my membership, inside the Hub. I'm just trying to think off my head. Who's just made frames recently? Oh, gosh, can't think of the name. That is really going to annoy me. Who was it? It's gone. The name's gone. But if I can remember, I will come back. But she was buying frames and then just realized it was getting costly. And she actually enjoyed making her own frames. And it's working very well for her. So her work is kind of consistently framed in the same way. And that works for her people. So, you know, it can work. You know, just make sure you do it properly, and that they look good and use quality materials is what I would say. But yeah, I've seen it work. So if I can remember who it is, I will send you the link, because she makes very, very nice frames, and she actually even posted on her Instagram recently how she makes them. I just need to remember who it was, because I see so many artists every day. I get confused. I think there's something quite, if you're that way inclined as well, there's something quite nice about making your own frames. Like I always used to make my own canvas bars. So I would make the frame for the canvas to sit on. And I used to love making those and stretching the canvas. And it's kind of just felt, I don't know, more involved in the whole of the process. But some people don't like that, you know. They just want to just take it to the framers, get someone else to do it. Oh, hello, Arena. It's your first time here, so welcome. Oh, love this, Siobhan. So Siobhan's an installation artist. I love exploring new ways of approaching a space I work in. I drew the painting on plastic, strung these up in an angle from the wall. Love it. Yeah, very liberating to explore presentation. Yeah, it's a key one, isn't it, Siobhan? And one thing that I came across recently, another artist, it was in an exhibition actually before the lockdown, so it was a while ago, but they were hung on wire. And, you know, kind of like floating down, and they were really lovely. So they had this kind of movement as well. And I liked that. So, yeah, you think out the box sometimes, out of the frame. Sorry, that's a really bad joke. Oh, Colin makes his own frames, but I am a furniture maker, so you have an advantage. We all need to get to Colin's. Hello, Sharon. One of my clients has an amazing art collection, originals, and the frames are awful. But he loves the fact that his art consultant told him an original valuable piece of art should never be reframed. Oh, wow. And always stay in its original frame, no matter how awful. Well, that's a lovely way of looking at it, isn't it? Because that's what the way it was intended. And I guess works like that, you're kind of messing around with them when you move them from one frame to another. I kind of understand this now, and actually saw his collection in a whole new light when he told me, and now I love them. Oh, I love that insight, Sharon. I think there is something to be said there, isn't there? That what you're just describing there is the why. So when we see something and we go, oh, I don't like that, when we learn more about why it's there in the first place, that just is a great example of how we can just suddenly change our opinion on something. So that goes for framing, it goes for presentation, it goes for artwork itself. As soon as you share more about why it is like that in the first place, you know, it can change someone's opinion. I love that. Irina says, I don't have this problem anymore. I draw and paint on A3 paper, then scan everything. I refine some of my work in Photoshop, prepare some of them for printing in various formats on special paper for graphics. So you don't have to do the whole framing thing anymore. Hi, Angie. Yeah, it can be costly. Yeah, that's a good idea. And then Judith's saying the same. I'm spending too much on framing for paintings that don't sell. I will start painting on box canvas, so it won't need framing. And then Lottie says, yeah, I leave mine unframed, given the option for the buyer to display as they choose, maybe just propped on a picture shelf or mounted on a board to hang frameless or framed to their taste. Yeah. See, there's no right or wrong, and I love how everyone's just shared their examples. So hopefully that's helped and give you some confidence. But one thing I would say is, don't be afraid to just, you know, approach people at the stage that you're at and show that you've considered the presentation and this is where I'm at, and be prepared for some feedback of, you know, not yet, but maybe if you do this and do that, we could take you on. And don't be afraid to ask questions either of the galleries and the people that you approach. Make it a two-way conversation. Ask them what they think sells. Ask them what they think in terms of framing and what has worked in their galleries. You know, you can go in and have a conversation about that. I'm just reading this comment from Will. Going back to one of your seminars from earlier this year, you said how useful it is to have a sketchbook with you whenever you can. I bought a new one yesterday and already have done a portrait of a friend in it. Good advice. Yay, Will. I love it. And in fact, next, I'm totally way ahead here, but next February, we're doing a whole sketchbook challenge. Because we are releasing Make Your Mark, which is a course that Sharon and I wrote years ago, and we're refreshing it. And so there's kind of a prequel to that course that we want to do for free for everybody. And it will all be about that gathering. It's about gathering things for your sketchbook and getting really into your work again. So that's it, guys. Happy Monday to you all. And if you are a Hub member, I will see you inside the Hub on Thursday for our live session. And I hope you all have the most wonderful week. If you are watching the replay, please feel free to leave comments below. If you liked the video, give it a like. And I will see you soon. Take care, everyone. Bye.